Hey BC, how's it going? Right, okay, a vinyl finds video, just some stuff that I picked up during the course of this month and at the end of last year. I'm going to start off though with some VCLT. So this is from James Griffiths. Now I was going to do a separate VCLT video, but nobody really watches those, if I'm honest, whenever I make them. So I've got a couple of things to show, which I'll show in the next couple of videos that I do. But I say this is from James. Bob Marley and the Wailers, Uprising, 1980. The last album that Bob Marley put out before he died. And I say I've got most of Bob Marley's records, but I'd never actually heard this all the way through. A couple of massive songs on here, Could You Be Loved? Obviously that was a big hit over in the UK, top five single. Redemption Song as well, the last track on the album. But the whole thing is gorgeous. I've been playing this copy, and when I've been out and about, I've been listening to it on my phone as well, just streaming it. But yeah, thanks for that, James. Great stuff. This is a reissue. I think he sent me this because he, I think he found an original copy of it, which sounded a bit better than this. But yeah, this is lovely, so really cool. Right, okay, I picked up a couple of LPs yesterday. First up, Nixon by Lamb Chop. Now, I think this came out in 2000. It doesn't sound about, I'm sure it came out in 2000, in which case, this is definitely one of the best albums of the 21st century. If it came out in 99, I'll perhaps have to retract that statement, but yeah. Brilliant record. So what happened was, in the mid-90s, I was really into Britpop, and then as the 90s progressed, that whole scene got a little bit stale. And around that sort of time, Uncut Magazine came out in the UK, and they were covering a lot of Americana bands such as Wilco, Whiskey Town, Mercury Rev, and Lamb Chop. Obviously, all those artists put out records around that sort of period. Great records, but I think this is the pick of the bunch. Now, it's a bit of a strange record though, because it's very lush sounding, some gorgeous string arrangements on here. It's quite soulful, but I've got to say, the band at times sound like they're not really trying, you know? Particularly the vocals. He's almost singing to himself. You know when you sing under your breath when you're doing something else, I don't know. Yeah, it sort of works. I mean, the songs are great. The songwriting is excellent throughout. 10 tracks. Doesn't outstate well, it's welcome. Yeah, an absolutely brilliant record. Same time, I picked up this record. This is on the Blue Note Classic series of reissues. The Green is Beautiful by Grant Green, 1970. Just classic soul jazz. Obviously, Grant Green, a guitarist. I know a lot of people don't necessarily like jazz guitar records. I do. And I say, this particular period, it's a real sweet spot for me. Now, the rhythm section on this is funky throughout. I mean, you've got Idris Muhammad on drums, Candido on congas, so, you know, it's got to be funky. But this pressing sounds absolutely incredible, as all of the Blue Note Classic series do. But, yeah, lovely record. So, give this a couple of spins this morning. Sounds fantastic. Okay, another reissue. This is Bitty McLean with On Bond Street. Now, this is a big one for me because this came out in 2004. I loved this record when it came out, so I got it on CD. I don't normally buy, or try not to buy, reissues on vinyl when I've already got them on CD, particularly if the CD sounds okay. But this, I say, one of my favourite albums. certainly the best, well, I said this to Steve Syke in the Valley the other day. I think this is the best reggae album of the 21st century. It's built around original Studio One rhythms, with Bit McLean putting new vocals over the top, new melodies, new lyrics. So it's got that feeling of being new, but also being old at the same time. And it works so well. Yeah, on the Peckins record label, you can get it on Bandcamp. Well worth every penny. So there you go. But it's just the feeling within me. When you touch my hand. Some you stuff. So I bought this a couple of weeks ago. This is Margie Joseph with her self-titled record, I think from 1973, on Atlantic Records. Now, she made a string of great records in the 70s. She originally recorded for Stax. Those records, you can still get them pretty cheap, actually. I mean, this only cost me a tenner. I already had a copy of this, although mine was slightly dog-eared. But this is a lovely copy, sounds great. But here she's basically recording with Aretha Franklin's band. You've got Bernard Purdy on drums, Cornell Dupree on guitar, Jeremy Jamont on bass. So, you know, absolutely killer band performing with her. Made up of a lot of cover version stuff like Let's Stay Together, the Al Green tune, I'm Only a Woman, I'd Rather Go Blind. But yeah, a really nice record. If you see her, say, any of those records up to, the late 70s, definitely worth picking up if you see for the right price, but lovely stuff. And I've been going back to Swordfish Records in Birmingham. I mentioned this shop a few times. They had a large soul, funk, jazz, hip-hop collection come in about sort of 7 or 8 months ago now. I've gone through it all. I've picked out the obvious stuff, the stuff that I wanted. So now I'm actually working just about 5 minutes away. So I sometimes pop in for half an hour just to sit and go through a box of record looking for stuff that I don't necessarily know. And I pulled out some nice 12s, which I'll show in another video, but I'll show some clips of the shop and I'll play some music from this album. This is the Bobby Timmons Trio, Easy Does It, on Riverside from 1960 or 61 it is. Some Micro Groove copy on the white Riverside label there. I really like, again, that soul jazz sound from Bobby Timmons. Obviously recorded a lot with Cannonball Adderley. Yeah, and anything on Riverside, I've said before, you know, even if you can see a few marks on the vinyl, they always sound great. The pressings are always fantastic. But this is a nice early 60s cool jazz record. And yeah, I'll show some footage of the shop. Couple of cheapies that I picked up from Swordfish. First up, She's Strange by Cameo. Yeah, really nice copy, only a fiver. This is a cheap record, actually. If you see any of those mid-80s Cameo records, pick them up. She's Strange, Single Life, or Word Up. They all sound fantastic, chock full of great tunes. Of all of those 70s funk bands, you know, the big horn funk bands, you know, likes of Earth, Wind & Fire, etc. Cameo made that transition, best of all of them, from that funk sound, that horn funk sound, through to the more electronic funk sound. And these three albums in particular really highlight that. But yeah, really nice stuff, and say a cheap record. John Lucien, I Am Now. Yeah, so this was only cost me £3, as you can see there. This is a reissue of his debut record. I think his debut came out about 1970, 71. This is a reissue from 77. I like the way that the ring wear on this record actually, you know, goes around the shape of his hair. That's pretty cool, isn't it? But yeah, I mean, this is vocal jazz. Very nice. Slightly funky in places, but more of a straight jazz sound. But yeah, nice. And finally, I've been going through boxes of 12 inches there. I'm going to do a separate video of some 12s that I picked up from Swordfish and from Music Is The Answer. Some really nice stuff. But yeah, this is a track by Arthur Adams called You Got The Floor. A great 12, I think from 1981. That sort of rare groove, boogie type sounds. And I'm going to do a needle drop on that because I never heard it before. And this is absolutely killer. So, cheers.
Now do what you're gonna do.